then we walked all the way across the park through the American Street or whatever it's called. And it was like San Francisco and New York and Chicago and all the other major cities all in one street, but it was all like forced perspective, so it was really like the size of the hotel room, but you felt like you were like in a street. And they had,
it was cool.
It was very cool. And they had Carrie's apartment from Sex and the City. I don't know if it was really it, but it looked like it. We're taking the backlot movie tour, and we're in line, and we're in the next group, and the guy comes out. He's like, we need 4 volunteers over the age of 16. I need we got to be in the tour like we were actors filming
a movie.
We filmed a movie, and me and Paige were the deck crew for the ship that the movie took place on, and we had to scrub the ship, and then we got splashed with lots of water. As did my mother, who was filming with my 2-day-old camera. Oh, then we get to this thing where they're like we're on a like a set of a movie called Disaster Cavern or something like that, and you're like in this like Grand Canyon type valley, and they're like, okay, we're gonna do the first take of the thing, and you're like in this little trolley car tour guide thing with no windows or anything, and they're like, okay, action, and it starts raining on the thing, but we're undercover, so we're like, oh, okay, no big deal. Then this fucking typhoon
of
water,
it's Animal Kingdom all over again.
It starts pouring over the edges of the set. Where it's coming from, I don't even know, because it just appears out of nowhere. And what they say, it was like 300 million gallons of water or something like that. Huge amounts of water spilling on us, and Mom's like in my lap. I wish I had my camera out, but I was so afraid it was going to get wet because I saw, like, water dripping, so I put it away. It was hysterical to just leave it at that. And then they recycled the water, and they did it again for the next group, so it was cool. Then we came home, and we went to the hot tub because the people that were still here that work with Mom were going to be at the hot tub.
I don't know if we should talk about this.
Let's just say there were drinks involved. Other people had drinks, and it was absolutely hysterical. Tiny Jim was like, you too need to get some fake IDs and come back here for the Food and Wine Festival. And I was like, okay. So then we were in the pool making fun of people, mostly Chris. We got up yesterday morning, Tuesday morning.
To the water park.
We didn't shower.
Nothing really important happened.
And I wasn't bringing my camera to a damn water park because I repel technology.
You really didn't need it because
we didn't need it because there's no place for you to like put it down when you go on the ride, because then I would have had to climb.
Chris!
Is it Chris?
I don't know.
They have like birds in the Typhoon Lagoon to like make it feel more tropical or whatever. And obviously, if people are eating French fries, the birds are gonna head for those people. And then these tools that were sitting next to us were like scaring the birds away, so I started throwing French fries by their table so that the birds wouldn't go near them. The whole thing is like a mountain, and all of the slides are in the one mountain, but you have to climb up the mountain every time you want to go on a new slide. And then there's a lazy river or whatever they call it. And then there's a wave pool that the whole thing is around, which is in a whole league of epicism. Is that a word? That's Hurricane Harbor could never even dream of, because this...
It's basically the Jersey Shore minus the salt water.
And minus the weeds. So it's better, really. The deepest section is like 6.5 feet, and if you swim all the way out to that, which I did, but she didn't, because she likes to stand in the 2-foot section when the wave comes, it like picks you up before the like white part starts coming on the wave, and it like just lifts you up, and you're sitting on top of the wave. It's awesome. And you're like 20 feet in the freaking air. It's great. It's actually calmer out there. But the only thing is you have to tread water for like 10 minutes while you're waiting for the wave to come. Not cool. That was that. That was the water park. It was fun. We went, we saw, we conquered.
Did you know that in Europe it's okay for men and women to wear the same bathing suit bottoms? Because...
Oh, I'm telling you, they sell unisex bathing suits.
Okay, I saw a husband and wife or brother and sister or I don't even know what the relationship was. It was a man and a woman and they had accents, so they were not from here. And they were wearing the same exact bathing suit, except she had a top on and he didn't.
Usually they don't wear
tops. It's just bet. It's not okay. If any of you ever go to Europe, wear an American bathing suit. And if any of our international fans, because I'm sure we have at least one, if you ever come to America, wear an American bathing suit.
Are you guys ready to go?
Are we done?
I think so. Is there anything else we have to cover?
No, I think we covered it.
Yeah.
Turn it off.
Can you turn it off while you're up?
Vacation, all I ever wanted. Vacation, had to get away. Vacation, meant to be spent with you. Vacation's all I ever wanted. Vacation, had to get away. Vacation, meant to be spent with you. Vacation's all I ever wanted. All I ever wanted. Vacation, had to get away. Vacation, meant to be spent with you.
Welcome to New Jersey.